Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, internet's busiest music nerd. Hope you're doing well. And I am now following up with a third edition of a series that I have not engaged in a long time on this channel, listing out in blocks of 10 some of the worst songs of my adolescence, my teen years, my tween years, my formative years in the 90s and 2000s. Even though many people these days look upon these years very positively, oh man, what a golden age of music. No, actually, it was loaded with total fucking garbage. That is why I can do tons of videos in this series. I haven't done one in a while though, but still,
here are
10 more awful songs from my adolescence in no particular order. Let's go. This first one we're talking about is a Korn song. Yes, the new metal band Korn, back in 1998, they dropped their record
Follow the Leader,
which was huge. Some big singles off of that record, some songs that to this day, I could still kind of get behind. You know, I could see why during the time they were big, why they were huge, and why I loved them. And their debut record is still kind of dank. Kind of dank for a new metal record, but there's a particular song off of this album that wasn't a huge, huge single, but it was one of the more popular tracks amongst the Korn fan base around that time. And it's this song called All in the Family, and it is this funny, somewhat tongue-in-cheek little rap battle between Jonathan Davis and Fred Durst. And given the rap acumen of both artists around that time, you can probably imagine without having heard this track, the quality of the verses going back and forth. We're talking a lot of dick mentions, Austin Powers reference, a little bit of homophobia too. It's really, really fucking stupid. Like, obviously this song wasn't meant to be taken super seriously, and clearly all parties involved were trying to just have some fun and crack wise, but the humor of this track has completely lost its luster over the years, and now it just sounds like a really dumb, stupid novelty that's not good. Not good. So that song's trash. That song is utter garbage. Another song that is utter garbage and came out not too long after this track in 1999 is the Limp Bizkit song Rollin', which around the time of their sophomore full-length album, which really was the record that broke them into the mainstream. You know, this song pretty much just personifies everything that was wrong with rap metal at the time. And not to say that everything was bad about rap metal around that time. Obviously, there were good groups during this time period who were making amazing rap metal, like Rage Against the Machine. But Limp Bizkit, I guess you could say,
embodies
everything that was wrong with rap metal at that time, in that it was just like, I don't know, very corny, annoying, masculine posturing with very little in terms of songwriting substance. This at the time is what white people thought hip-hop was all about. Just like, looking cool! Yeah! When in fact you're trying too hard and you just fucking suck. Keep rolling, 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 yeah! Rolling, 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 yeah! And look, some of y'all might be seeing this video and thinking, Anthony, why pick this song? Why not pick Nookie? Why not pick this? Why not pick that? Well, there will be more videos in this series, okay? There will be more videos in this series, but still, keep in mind, Rollin' is trash. Next, Crazy Town, Butterfly, 2001. In a way, I do give Crazy Town credit because they were one of the few bands around this time that were blending a lot of different styles of rock music and loud rock music that weren't necessarily crossing into each other in this space. They did have songs that were super aggressive, super heavy, a lot funkier, a lot more nu metal oriented, but this is one of their tracks that was just very much more of a straight pop song with glistening guitars, a funky beat. It's like if Linkin Park had no redeeming values whatsoever. Not only that, but the lyrics on this track are utter garbage. I mean, just looking at them, come my lady, come my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar, baby. Just leave me alone. You are coming on way too strong. Stay back. Stay away. Just get away from me. Ah! Next, this song comes from one of the suckiest bands of the 90s and the 2000s, a band that I am floored did not make it into this series earlier, but that's Creed. Arms Wide Open. Yeah, this is like one of the most anthemic, overblown, overly sentimental garbage songs I've ever heard in my life. Every time I hear that fluttery guitar and Scott Stapp just, it just makes me cringe internally to the point where I'm really losing a year or two off of my life. I mean, look, I know that if you check me out here, I may seem like I'm in my 30s, but I am just a teenager. That is how much hearing this track on the radio has aged me. It's also worth mentioning that Scott Stapp is easily one of the worst singers of this era of music. I mean, you really got to give it to Eddie Vedder. He created an entire strain within alternative rock where for well over a decade, men were allowed to sing like this, and people thought it was okay, when in fact it was not okay, and it sucked, and it was a bad idea, and it should have never happened. Now, Pearl Jam is a much more respected band than Creed. Nobody disrespects Pearl Jam openly. People like Pearl Jam. People see Pearl Jam as an artistically viable band, but they also do not get away easy in this list. They are in this list too. And the way that Pearl Jam has made their way into this list is through their 1999 cover of the song Last Kiss, which when I was a kid was the most overplayed thing on the radio ever. Now this song, if you're familiar with it, is this old rock and roll tune from the 60s, didn't hit as big as it could have back in the day, and it's this teen pop rock song that's essentially about a tragedy where you're taking your girl out in your daddy's car and you have a car crash and she dies in the car crash, and before those moments where she passes away, you're having your last kiss. It's a very dramatic song. It's very cute. And Pearl Jam instrumentally, I guess, tries to do their best to stick to the original blueprint of the song, but they've really lost the original charm of this track. And that mostly comes in the form of Eddie Vedder singing. His voice does not sound good on this song at all.
Hold me, darling, just a little while. She's gone to heaven, so I got to be good, so I can see my baby when I live.
Next track here is a novelty song from a project by the name of Rednecks. Cotton Eye Joe is the name of the single. Now, if you guys didn't grow up in the 90s, because this track dropped in 1994, and maybe if you didn't grow up in the 90s, you've probably heard this played, I don't know, at a wedding or something. Either way, decades ago, there was this miniature little strain of electronic music coming out of Europe, Eurodance, that was very popular at the time. You can look at a track like Barbie Girl for an example of maybe the most popular and artistically viable track to come out of that genre around that time to hit it as big as it did. And a group of Swedes thought, hey, this Eurodance thing is so cool, let's do a song in this style, but like an American country bluegrass version, where it's like, you know, a real, the beat is annoying, the chanting is annoying, the banjo on this track is annoying, all the finger picking's annoying. It's one of the most annoying songs of this generation. And I'm not sure what else I can really say about it. It's annoying as fuck. If you're young and you've never heard of this song before, play it. Believe me, it will make you just like drop to your knees instantly and just like pray to Jesus. And you will say, Jesus, God, Lord, baby Jesus, our Lord and Savior, Lord, baby Jesus, Lord Jesus, baby Savior, Jesus, baby Lord Jesus. Thank you. Thank you so much for making sure that I was a 2000s baby. Thank you so fucking much. Next, we have another song that is a cover that ruins the original. A track from the Guess Who, American Woman, a really great classic rock track that, you know, kind of has a lot of stank on it, a lot of swagger. It's really badass 1970s rock tune. But Mr. Lenny Kravitz not only ruined the track decades later with his horrendous version, but also, like, this is easily one of the dude's most popular songs. If not for this track, like, would this dude's profile even be as big as it is? I mean, I know he has
Fly Away,
and people loved that song back in the day, but goddamn, it's like, I see more people referencing this American Woman track as if he wrote the goddamn song when he didn't. But still, Lenny's version is just this completely boring, watered down, kind of funky classic rock take that is just so goddamn stale, or at least it was around the time when it came out. I find Lenny's nasally vocals on this track annoying too. Just do not care for this version at all. Just do not care for it. It's just terrible. This next one comes from a boy band. I know I haven't mentioned too many boy bands in this series so far, but look, back in the day, we had a bit of a golden age for boy bands. You know, we had NSYNC, we had Backstreet Boys, and looking back on a lot of that stuff and taking that in context with the grander scheme of boy band music in general, going back to New Kids on the Block, going today with One Direction. I mean, NSYNC and Backstreet Boys, they got the best hits. They had the most slaps of any boy band era so far, in my opinion. But that does not mean that there weren't some bad boy bands around that time that were coming out with some terrible music. I did talk about LFO once in this series. Certainly 98 Degrees were pretty mediocre, though not the worst that you'll ever hear. But the group that I'm talking about in this section is going to be a band by the name of O-Town. Not a very well-known band, mostly because they never didn't really hit it that big. They were the result of an MTV show that was popular or basically created or produced around this time in order to create a boy band that might become a sensation. It was called Making the Band. And one of their big first initial hits, or rather big for them anyway, was this track called Liquid Dreams. Okay, Liquid Dreams. Now, not only is the song awful, because when you hear it, beat's generic as fuck, and half the vocals on it are trash. The singing is straight garbage, especially like the third or fourth verse on the song, who sings that I can't remember because I don't care to. But the singing on the track sucks. By boy band standards, it's shit. But the worst thing about this track is that it's literally about fantasizing about hot women, like celebrity women. There are references to Madonna and Destiny's Child in this track. So it's about fantasizing about hot celebrity women while you sleep and having a wet dream and pretty much coming on yourself. So the track is about getting horny, coming on yourself and having a wet dream. And that's the fucking song. This track is garbage on so many levels. It's about cum, it's about you coming on you when you're sleeping, having hot horny dreams about Beyonce, and with bad vocals and a bad instrumental. So yeah, that's O-Town. Come all over yourself. Next in my list here, I'm talking about another crap track that came out in 1999. A lot of terrible stuff coming out in 1999, frankly. Kid Rock's Cowboy. This rock, country, rap epic is total shit as it ever was. The song is just like this really ugly, stupid, jokey, but trying to make it sound cool stereotype of what cowboys and people from the South are. And not to say that I don't have my own criticisms about the South and cowboy culture and Southern culture, I certainly do. But Kid Rock pretending to be like a cool rebel cowboy is just really fake. I wonder why people who were Southern, or why people who were cowboys, or people who were country fans around this time actually embraced this song, because again, it just seems like a really bad stereotype and satire in retrospect of what that culture and what that section of the country actually is. Just seems really out of touch, and it seems like Kid Rock is mostly just like functioning off of a caricature. So song's obnoxious, the humor in the song falls flat, and yeah, just generally a crap song. Cowboy, Kid Rock. Sucks. All right, this last track I'm gonna mention in this list, and this will be the end of the video, came out in 2003. So this is really the tail end at which I can enter songs into this time frame, because this is the year that I graduated high school. Really pushing it past this year. I'm not talking about my adolescence or my high school years anymore, my junior high years. Then I would be referencing songs that came out when I was in college. But still, 2003, a track from the band Hoobastank, who at one point used to be kind of like a funk rock and a ska punk band for a little bit, but then they progressed into this very soft rock, alternative rock, post-grunge style, as many bands were during that time, because they wanted to sound sad and boring and utterly soulless. And Hoobastank made that transition with one of the biggest rock singles of that decade, and that is the song The Reason. And look, there's some nice things about this track. This track isn't total shit. It's not totally garbage. I think the production is fairly good. I think the progression of the instrumentation is pretty nice as well. It's subtle, it's nuanced. I think the vocal performance is decent as well. I just personally cannot stand the melodrama of this track. It is just so hard to take in. I'm not a perfect person. I want you to know. It's just so much. They lay the melodrama on so heavily. I just cannot stand it. It's just so overwhelming. And that's essentially my key issue, my biggest issue, my main issue with this song. It's just so, it's just so overly sentimental. I can't digest it. It just makes me constipated, is essentially the effect this song has on my musical digestion. It's just so much cheese. You can't eat too much cheese or you're just not going to crap for a week. You need fiber. You need that fiber in there. And I'm going to leave it at that. Those are 10 more awful, god-awful, terrible, not good songs from my adolescence that I hope to never have to hear again, especially Liquid Dreams, especially Liquid Dreams. You guys are the best. I love you. Transition, have you given any of these songs a listen? I hope not. Let me know down in the comments what you thought of any of them, if you have heard them before in your life. If you have, I'm sorry. I feel bad for you. And I'll see you in the next video. Maybe we'll do another one of these sooner rather than later if I'm thinking of some terrible songs from when I was a kid and having some terrible flashbacks to when I was younger. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, songs, adolescence, bad, forever.